everybody. Welcome to the Tourist Trap, Scott again. Today I'm at Disney's Hollywood Studios. I'm going to show you the connection between the Dukes of Hazzard cast and Hollywood Studios, Walt Disney World, and Disney movies that you may or may not know about. The last one, I'm going to save to the last, that no one knows about an attraction here at this park that a person on the Dukes of Hazzard, not an actor, had his hand in, and for many years was part of that attraction. Many of you will be very surprised to find out who that is. He was an exceptional person in Hollywood. Had the chance to talk to him several times before he passed away. So let's go and explore some of the things that are Dukes of Hazzard related that are connected to Disney World, Hollywood Studios, and Disney movies. Ironically enough, I wasn't in the park 3 to 5 minutes. Security was all over me. They was like, "What are you doing? You look like you know what you're doing. I've seen you out front taking pictures like you knew what you were doing." I was like, "Wow." He's like, "You are not an ordinary guest." I said, "Nope, not an ordinary guest at all. I used to be a cast member," and then proceeded to tell them that I represented TV actor Sonny Schroyer from the Dukes of Hazzard and what I was doing. And very interesting conversation I had. He was very nice. Told him some of the videos I was working on here. But they are all over it here with Disney security. Didn't get in any trouble or anything because I'm not doing anything wrong. So just found that very, very quite interesting that they were on me so fast, wanting to know what I was up to. So they are watching. There's a lot of plainclothes security in the parks. You don't know there's security. So they're watching everything. They thought maybe I might be up there recording their metal detectors. It's some big secret device, I guess. So they're suspicious of everything. This right here is one of the original statues still remaining here in this park since its opening day of May 1st, 1989, when it opened up as Disney's MGM Studios. And the placard is still over here of the opening statements of then CEO Michael Eisner, who opened this park prior to the opening of Universal Orlando. They always had this here on the back burner. It wasn't going to be a park. It was actually going to build an attraction at Epcot called Journey Through the Movies. And they said, "No, this is way much bigger than that. We're going to build a park. We're going to build a studio." So, and that's what they did. And probably more than likely, it's basically this great movie ride was the inspiration for the whole park, because Journey Through the Imagination of the Movies was going to be placed at Epcot between the land and the Imagination Pavilion. And Michael Eisner says, "No, no, no. He says, it's much bigger than one attraction. Let's build a park." And they did, and they spent some money. I am walking through the Pixar area of the studio. One of the other things that Sonny Schroyer has done with Disney is one of the first productions that was ever shot here at the studios when it was called Disney MGM Studios. Sonny Schroyer was in an episode of Superboy, which was directed by Jackie Cooper from The Little Rascals. Not a lot of people know that. Some people do. He played a bad guy. I told him the other day I was doing this video. He's the only cast member from Dukes that knows that I'm doing this video. I do talk to him quite often. He's like a second father to me. I've known him a little over half my life, booking his appearances since 1992. And our link's in the description of our website and all that. But he started out, he did a couple Disney movies of the week with Disney's Wonderful World of Color And that's what took him to Hollywood, is what he told me on the phone the other day. And that was the $1 Million Dixie Deliverance and the Young Runaways. And also in the $1 Million Dixie Deliverance, Ben Jones, who played Cooter, he was in that film as well. Around that time, Sonny and him did a series of films. They ended up in the same films together because they both lived in Georgia. Ben living in Conyers, Georgia, Sonny living in Valdosta. But Sonny said, make sure you mention that those two Disney movies of the week took me to Hollywood. So there you go, Sonny. They actually took him to Hollywood, and he was able to, career just took off from there. I am standing outside of the soundstage for the Little Mermaid live show, and the reason for that is, I want to give you a little bit of information about an actor who was not on Dukes, but he was Sonny Schroeder's partner on the Enos TV series, which was a spinoff from Dukes of Hazzard. Samuel E. Wright. He played Turk when Sonny went to the Los Angeles Police Department and became an LAPD officer. Well, Samuel E. Wright, many people may or may not know, is the voice of Sebastian in the movie The Little Mermaid. He's did all the voices for Sebastian for every different production. A lot of people don't know that Samuel E. Wright from the Enos series is the voice of Sebastian in The Little Mermaid. Looks like we got some invasion of Toy Story toy soldiers coming at me here, right when I'm trying to do something. It seems like every time I've turned around in this park and want to talk about something, there's some kind of noise, some kind of parade, some kind of music, or a crowd. So I have moved back here to the area where they're doing some construction work, where there's not a lot of people. So I can see if we can see anything, improvements. They've knocked down a lot of stuff on Streets of America to build the Toy Story land and Star Wars land. I can see from the back of this soundstage, you can still see an old poster of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, which was right over top of where the Honey, I Shrunk the Kids place, Adventure Set, used to be located and is now being destroyed. Another little gem that Sonny Schroeder was in was a movie with Bill Cosby, not shot here at this studio, of course. It was a Disney film called The Devil and Max Devlin. Look that up if you care to. Well, those are a few connections Sonny Schroeder had with Disney. Launched his road to Hollywood, Disney's Wonderful World of Color, the two films he did for a movie of the week for that. And also one of the first productions here in the studio when it was still named Disney's MGM Studios, which was Superboy. Also Samuel E. Wright from the Enos series, voice of Sebastian. A lot of people didn't know that. Now we're going to go talk about Mr. John Schneider, Tom Wopat, Sorrel Book, and Uncle Jesse, Denver Pyle, with their connections with Disney movies and Disney World. Only one of them with Disney World, but Tom and John have a connection with a show on the Disney Channel. So let's go over to Magic Kingdom right now, and we'll talk about one actor who was part of a celebration here at Walt Disney World. And like magic, we have arrived at Disney's Magic Kingdom, all the way from Hollywood Studios. Didn't even need the park hopper for that. It's Disney magic. I'm out here in front of the castle where John Schneider from Dukes of Hazzard was on the 10th anniversary of Walt Disney World back in 1981, and I do believe it happened somewhere right along this area right here, because that does look like the angle. I'm going to see if I can't get a freeze shot to throw in here right now, and I think that's the area, because the rest of this is mostly water down in here in a moat. But it did look like a grassy area to the to the right, if you're looking at the castle, to the right of the castle, to where he was located, setting, singing a song, practicing his song for a concert. But they did set up an RV. Dana Plato from Different Strokes and Ricky Schroeder, back in the day, this was back in 81 when Silver Spoons and Different Strokes was on, they were playing themselves. They came on and she was like a big fan wanting to go to the John Schneider concert, so they posed as his agent or something like that. But I do believe, I'm going to show you right up here where I think that they parked his dressing room RV at the entrance to Tomorrowland. It does look like that from the video. I'm going to get a freeze frame of that. I'm going to try and see if we can compare. I do believe that's where it was setting. Right over here to the right of the castle, I do believe the RV was setting right in this vicinity, right over in this area, when they did that shot with Dana Plato and Ricky Schroeder, when they was trying to get to talk to John Schneider, and I believe it was set up right in here. From what I seen from the video, we're gonna go to a screenshot and see if it does match up. I do believe it is this walkway. And two other actors from Dukes also did a couple movies. They did some movies of the week. Denver Pyle, he did, I believe he did a movie of the week, but I think he did a movie of the week. He actually was in Escape to Witch Mountain and Return to Witch Mountain prior to doing Dukes of Hazzard. So that was Denver Pyle in those. And also, some people may not know that Sorrel Hook played Boss Hogg. He was in the 1976 movie, I believe it was 76, with Jodie Foster, Disney film, the original Freaky Friday. So there's another Disney connection with the Dukes between Uncle Jesse and Boss Hogg. As I'm walking through Tomorrowland here, thinking about, it's kind of a, we used to have the merchandise for the cartoon Phibious and Ferb, which is on the Disney Channel. And a lot of people might not know that John Schneider, Bo Duke, and Tom Lopat, Luke Duke, voiced some voices on a couple episodes of Phibious and Ferb for the Disney Channel, and they were brothers. I think it's Wilkins brother number one and Wilkins brother number two. Haven't seen those episodes, but how ironic that both of them came on to that show having played two cousins together, and here they are voicing two brothers together. So who would have thought that? So let's go back to Hollywood Studios for a few more Dukes connections that you might not know about. And by Disney magic, here we go. I am magically back to Disney's Hollywood Studios to wrap things up. It's been fun. Hope you've learned some information about Dukes of Hazzard characters, Dukes of Hazzard actors, and their connection to Disney films, Walt Disney World, and the like. So I'm going to leave it at that. You can do more research online on International Movie Database if you choose to. The ones I found is some I already knew. I know about everything about Mr. Sonny Schroyer. I did check some of the other actors. Peggy Ray, she did do a movie of the week for Disney's Wonderful World of Color. She was Lulu Hogg. So several of them, you know, have that Disney connection. Unfortunately, the Starring Roles Cafe, which was a very popular little breakfast place, has closed, and I think permanently. They have a little sign up here that says to go to the Trolley Car Cafe. Not sure what they're going to put in Starring Roles. Hopefully a food place. Maybe they're going to expand the Brown Derby. I'm not sure. But not sure why they would take it out. But it's out. It's gone. One of the first attractions that was in this park, and it's still in this park, is the Great Movie Ride, A Spectacular Journey Through the Movies. They used to have a ceremony out here in the front. When the park first opened, they used to do a Celebrity of the Week, and they would do a little cement hand and foot ceremony up here in front of the Chinese Theater. You got Kermit the Frog there and Dustin Hoffman. I remember one time I came up here and they had David Leisure from Empty Nest, which is a spinoff from the Golden Girls, and Alex Trebek was here once when I was here. Here's Charlton Heston's prints right there. And you got Michael J. Fox from Back to the Future right there. They don't no longer do that. It was a very cool little parade that they had when they did do this with the celebrities and their footprint little ceremony. It's pretty cool. Now this is the big reveal right here from Dukes of Hazzard and this studio. The Great Movie Ride, which is right behind me, the entrance is. A lot of people don't know this, but the original narration inside the ride, if you look it up online, or if you can remember, I remember some of the dialogue. If you remember in the cars, they had an automated spill in some portions of the ride. You go to the alien part, it says, "This is alien, you are with Sigourney Weaver, something has gone wrong." Well, the person who actually did the narration for that, the gentleman who called me several years ago by the name of Bruce Howard. Bruce was a writer for Dukes of Hazzard, later became the scripts consultant on the show The Dukes of Hazzard. He had a long list of credits before he got to Dukes of Hazzard. He was doing I Dream of Jeannie, and he wrote episodes of The Brady Bunch, one called The Not So Rose Colored Glasses, where Jan gets the glasses and ruins the painting. And it was a pleasure to talk to him. The different times that I did talk to him, he was calling me to get a hold of Sonny Schroyer. He hadn't lost contact with Sonny, and he had had multiple mini strokes, he had said. But I told him that anytime I seen an episode is written by Bruce Howard, it was always a good story. It was always a good episode. Too many to mention. One was Canterbury Croc. But anyways, that's the big thing that some people may not know. It's Bruce Howard, writer, script consultant for The Dukes of Hazzard, was the original narrator of The Great Movie Ride at Hollywood Studios, formerly Disney MGM Studios. So if you did not know that, I've told you something new. Bruce was very, very proud of the fact that he was the narrator of this attraction here at Disney World. So and it is listed on the International Movie Database with his credits. Fires and stuff was going off over here and explosions and really scared me there. He was in an episode of I Dream of Jeannie where he was in the jail cell with Major Nelson. He also wrote that episode. I can't remember the name of the episode right offhand. But check him out on International Movie Database. He will be listed as the narrator of The Great Movie Ride here at Hollywood Studios, now known as Hollywood Studios. And one more note on the Great Movie Ride. Just recently, the new narrator, Robert Osborne, passed away suddenly in his sleep. He was 86 years old. Not sure what Disney is going to do. They just updated this attraction last year with him in the pre-show and in the finale. Not sure what's going to happen with that, if he's still going to be in there, if they're going to re-update it again. We will have to wait and find out. One other note is Christopher Hensel, who played Jeb Stuart Duke on an episode called Along Came a Duke in season 3. He was the character Gaston in the Beauty and the Beast stage show, which he was on tour with that. If you want to check out his website or book him for an appearance, go to jebstuartduke.com. And one more thing to note about Dukes of Hazzard and Disney is season 2, season 3, they shot at the Disney Ranch, which is otherwise known as the Golden Oaks Ranch out in California, which is about less than half an hour from Los Angeles. Very, very old setting where they actually shot the little mini episodes called Spin and Marty for the original Mickey Mouse Club back in the 50s when Walt Disney was alive. They also did several other movies. Herbie the Love Bug was shot there. Several other TV series have shot there. BJ and the Bear. I'm going to put a link for Golden Oak Ranch there in the description. They have recently updated there since Dukes was there. They kind of run Dukes of Hazzard off there because they were tearing up the pastures and stuff with the cars, I believe. That's what Jimmy Best told me. But anyways, they have built a town set there now, of at least three or four different street sets that they're shooting productions with at the Golden Oak Ranch, otherwise known as the Disney Ranch. I remember they used to tell me that the Boar's Nest, right behind the Boar's Nest, was a big country club golf course, but you never did see that on camera. Bruce Howard, of course, being the narrator of the great movie Ride, who was the script consultant on the Dukes of Hazzard, and various other shows like I Dream of Jeannie and the Brady Bunch. He has a long list of credits, very impressive list of credits, as well as James Best and Denver Pyle. Their list is so long, I could probably, if I took some time, I could probably find some other things that Mr. Denver Pyle has done for Disney besides Escape from Witch Mountain and Return to Witch Mountain. But he's just got such a big resume of so many films. He was a legend in Hollywood. So don't have that kind of time to research, but you can do the research on your own. There's a lot of Hazzard connections to Disney. And hope you enjoyed all the information that I could provide you today at Hollywood Studios and a portion at Magic Kingdom. So I'm going to say goodbye and remember to go out there and make it a great day because you deserve it.